FM News. On point.
Thank you for joining us. Let's take a quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. Police is still investigating circumstances under which a journalist was seriously injured after being hit with a tear gas canister, or what is thought to be a rubber bullet. This after Ashraf Kassidier, attached to Ghetto TV crew, sustained deep cut injury above his left eye. According to a statement released by police spokesperson Fred Enanga, police in Greater Masaka had violent confrontations with a NUP candidate, Robert Kyagulanyi, and his supporters at a checkpoint in Chabakuza after they defied the route plan agreed upon to Chotela District. Enanga said the victim was rushed to Masaka Referral Hospital for medical attention while stable but in critical condition and was later transferred to Kampala for better management. Charles Twine, CID spokesperson, asked anyone with digital evidence regarding the disturbing incident to share it with the task team of investigators from CID headquarters.
Have commenced to establish the circumstances under which the incident took place. Uganda police appreciate the most critical role the journalists are doing in covering the ongoing presidential, parliamentary, as well as local council elections, and further pledge our commitment to give a better protection cover for the journalists to remain safe while covering such incidents.
Meanwhile, the National Unity Platform presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi sent him has suspended his campaigns after three journalists on his campaign trail were critically injured in a scuffle between the police and NUP supporters. The injured include Ashraf Kassidier, Ghetto Media, Daniel Rutai of NBS TV, and Ali Mivule, working with NTV Uganda. Kyagulanyi, who was expected in Rengo, Bukoma, Simbi, and Mpiji district, suspended his campaigns to take Kassidier to hospital for further management. Kassidier sustained a deep injury on the head, believed to be caused by a rubber bullet, bled profusely before he was taken to Masaka Regional Referral Hospital in critical condition. By the time of his injury, Kassidier was on top of Kyagulanyi's car, covering the campaign live and the standoff between the police and Kyagulanyi at Chabakuza, 7 kilometers away from Masaka City along the Masaka Mbara Road. NUP Vice President for Central Region, Matthias Mpuga, said that Kassidier is in a critical condition, so Kyagulanyi had to suspend his campaigns to take him to hospital, but they will be letting the country know when he will resume his campaigns again. Mpuga condemned the police action, which he said was targeting members of the media. Efforts to get a comment from police in Masaka were futile, as police avoided commenting on the incident. National Resistance Movement General Secretary Justin Kasule Lumumba has challenged the Electoral Commission to come out with a clear explanation and new directives that suspended campaigns in COVID-19 hotspot districts. On Saturday, the Electoral Commission issued directives that suspended campaign activities of all categories in districts such as Kampala, Wakiso, Jinja, Mbale, Kalungu, Masaka, Tororo, Mbarara, Kabarole, Kasese, and Kazo as one of the ways of controlling further spread of COVID-19. However, during the party weekly press conference at Chadendo, Lumumba revealed that a number of questions were not addressed in the directives, hence calling for a dialogue.
If you have restricted political activities in these particular 12 districts that have been mentioned, if a candidate decided to carry people from that district to another district, is it allowed? Are you restricting only political activities in that district, yet you have not restricted movements of people from that district to another? So these are issues that will need a discussion with us as stakeholders and the Electoral Commission. I think even scientists with the Ministry of Health, so that these are really answered and we find a way forward.
Meanwhile, Lumumba has condemned the excessive use of force by police and other security agencies while enforcing COVID-19 guidelines. Lumumba was reacting to the Masaka incident yesterday, where National Unity Platform supporters and journalists on the campaign trail of Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu got injured.
What I can say is that every life is important. We wouldn't want to lose a life. So whoever is in charge, law enforcement officers, yes, do your work, but also be protected from those who also want to hurt you and harm you, but also we should ensure that we guard against losing any life. Life is life. There is no rehearsal in death. Once one is gone, is gone. So let's ensure we all work together, we all work hard in whatever capacity or wherever you are to avoid violence and intimidation, because it affects many and you cannot choose the reaction of your actions from the other people.
In other news, South Africa has become the first country on the continent to register more than 1 million COVID-19 cases. It comes just days after authorities confirmed that a new faster-spreading coronavirus variant had been detected. Some hospitals and medical centers have reported a huge rise in admissions, putting a heavy strain on resources. President Cyril Ramaphosa is widely expected to announce tougher restrictions to prevent the virus from spreading further. The grim milestone was announced Sunday by South Africa's Health Minister Zweli Mkhize. The country has now confirmed 1,004,413 COVID-19 infections and 26,735 deaths since the outbreak began in March. Last week, South Africa recorded a daily average of 11,700 new infections, a rise of 39% from the previous week. And from Wednesday to Friday, the daily number of new cases was above 14,000. The new coronavirus variant, known as 501 virus 2, is believed to be driving the surge in infections. It was identified by a network of South African scientists in the Eastern Cape province and then rapidly spread to other parts of the country. And that was the news.